Hello friends, this video is specially meant for the students because it's been created on students' demand. They wanted me to create another video on digital portfolio and to deal with it a little more in detail. Also, that I should go at a slightly slower pace. So I've tried to take care of both of these factors and I hope that it's going to be useful to all the students. So let's not waste any time and start immediately. So first, let's understand what is a portfolio. So portfolio is a collection of your work throughout the academic year. So whatever work you have done throughout the academic year, which is worth mentioning, should be put inside the portfolio. So let's see, what are those things which can be included in the portfolio? So first is that you have to be writing something about yourself, because anyone who is browsing through your portfolio should first know you. And when you're introducing yourself, write a few lines about yourself. You can mention about your interests and hobbies, some talent or passion that you have. What are those words which you feel describe you? What are your strengths and what are your weaknesses? If you've already decided about what your life's goal is, you can mention that. So that will be very nice for anyone to go through your portfolio, because they will now know a little about you, and then mention about your achievements. So at the international level or national level, state, district, city level, inter-school level or intra-school level, if you've participated in any competitions, if you've participated in any events, you've organized a particular event, anything that you have done and you've received certificates and awards, that is something which can be mentioned in achievements. Then you can mention about various performances which you did. So it could be a theatrical performance, dancing, singing, playing some kind of an instrument, art and craft work, or where you have put your sports related skills on display. Any of these things, if you have done, it can be put under performances. Another thing which you have to do is to add the subject related artifacts. Now that could be something creative writing that you have done, or you have read a few books. So you can put the cover page of the book and write a little bit of reviews on it. You have taken up project work. Every subject teacher gives you some of the other project work to do. You can upload the project work over there. Any research work that you have undertaken, any experiments that you have performed, all of that can get inside your portfolio. The different creative assignments that you have done, that can find place in the portfolio. All your test scores should be put up in your portfolio. If you have attempted anything online, say live worksheets or quiz or anything on the Google Forms, you can upload that. If your teacher has given you some subject enrichment activities, that can be uploaded. And also it's important that you reflect on your progress. So for each subject, you can have a small tab for reflections wherein you are trying and assessing your own performance, comparing it from your previous performance to this performance. So even your reflections can find place in the portfolio. So now that we have understood that what are the things which can be included in portfolio, let's now start working on the portfolio. So to begin with, you will first go to sites.google.com. Always remember that you are logged into the correct Gmail ID, or if your school has provided you a particular domain ID, then you should be first logged into that ID and then go to sites.google.com. Now we'll move on to portfolio. Okay. So firstly, we will change the name. We'll put our name over here. Suppose this portfolio is being created for Ayushman Khurana. So we'll put the name here and then a small introduction. Now, if you want, you can just change the font, whichever you like. You can change the font size. You can make it bold. So there are a lot of formatting options here which you can use. And you want to now change the picture. So remove this and you want to add the image. So if you want to add the image, you can go to insert. When you go to images, you can upload anything which is there on your computer. For convenience sake, whatever I have to upload, I have put it in one folder in the Google Drive. So I'll go to the drive and then select that folder. And I'll select the picture. Insert. So I'll just put the picture over here. Now you see, you can crop this image and you can, whatever you want to select and keep in the image is something which you can keep. So maybe I want to keep the image like this. And I want to resize the image. So you can resize it. All right. Now, here you can write something about yourself. So, hello, I am a sports enthusiast and love to play guitar. My friends say that I'm good at listening and problem solving. So whatever you want to write about yourself, you can write. Then this, because this is your front first page, the home page, any of your selected work can find place on the front page of your portfolio. So suppose you have created a nice presentation and you want to upload it. So you will go here. It'll open the slides. Already this presentation was open for me. So I'll just insert this presentation. And then change the name of this. All right. Similarly, if you want to any of the images, then you just directly go to, I'm going to the drive because I have everything in the drive. Now select an image, yes, and insert. So the image comes here. And you can name it as Nature's Beauty. Then if you want to upload a video, then if you click on this, it says from YouTube. If you have, if you're directly integrating something which is there on the YouTube, you can just put the URL over here. Or otherwise, you can directly go to your drive, right? And then you can select a video. I'm selecting this video and I'll insert. Now I don't want this box. So what I'll do is I can just delete this box. And I can drag my video here, resize it. Now I want to insert a text box just to give a name. So I'll double click. As I double click, this will open and this is for text. So the text box will be there and you can name it. Here it is, velocity of the cart on the track, right? So you've inserted your work over here. Now see, you can make changes in the background. This is one particular section. And so if you want, you can just change the background of it. You can upload an image so that image can come in the background. Now, if you don't want this particular section, you can just delete it. This whole section can be deleted. Now let's see what are the other things which are available with us. So we have got these layouts. So if I want, I can use this as a layout. And I can insert maybe images over here, some text here, whatever we want to insert. If you just double click, it is giving us all the options to insert an image, anything from the drive, from YouTube, integrate calendar or map. So you now know how to do this. So I'm just deleting this section. Suppose you want to be using collapsible text. Now, when do we use a collapsible text? When we have got a big text and we don't want that the whole thing should appear. So let me just copy a big text over here. Let's say this one. Okay, I'm just copying this much. And I'll put the text here. So now the text is here and I'll copy the heading of this. Suppose I've written an article, so you can say article on, so this is your heading. You can decrease the size of the box. Now, see the text is gone, but anyone who wants to read it can just click on this arrow and can read it. And there is another thing which is image carousel. So you can image carousel means it will keep displaying your images if you have uploaded multiple images. So for this you should have at least, you know, two images or more than two images. So I'll add the image here. This says select image and it is opening my drive now. I'll go to my portfolio and select the images and selected a few images here and insert. Right. So the images are inserted. Now you can go to the settings button. If you want that the for each image dots should show, so you can click on this. If you have put some captions there, you can you know, click on this. If you want that it should auto start and keep moving, what should be the pace of the movement? Very slow, slow, medium. So let's keep it as medium and then insert. So this thing has been inserted. Now let's just resize it. And if you want, you can make it full big in this manner. Right. Now you've made this big. Now let's, you can see here, we had uploaded three images. So three dots are appearing. And if you want, you can see the preview of how will it look like to people when they see your portfolio. This is how it's going to look. Now see, it's moving on its own. I'm not doing anything. It's moving on its own. This is how it is moving, right? So I'm exiting the preview now. So you can keep on previewing your portfolio also, that how will it look to people. Suppose you want to introduce a button here. So let's say button, and you want that on the home page, it should be about you. So you can just create a button of about me and then link it to this particular page and insert. And if you want to move this button up and you want it to be here just below, so you can put the button over here. When anyone will click on this button, say let's go to the preview again. So if anyone will go on the button, you will find that this about page will open. We have not populated the content as yet, so we'll check it out. Now here on the home page, you know that we've kind of done, put up some stuff here. There is another thing which is known as themes. So you can change the theme of your page. There are various options. Say if you want to go here, you can see that the color has changed, the style has changed. If you want to change the color, there are options of different colors which are given here. You can see this. And even this selection of the color has also changed over here, you can see. Right, if you want to do this, it has changed. It depends upon you. What do you want? Okay, which color do you want? You want it in this manner, so the background color of your page will change. And so you can make changes the way you want. The theme will change. All right. So the first page is something which we have now understood how to work on our portfolio and create the first page. The second page is invariably about you. Here you can upload your picture. Even you can put an image carousel over here like we did on the first page, on the home page. You can write all that which you want to tell about yourself, which you want people to know. You can write about your interests, about your passion. You can write about your strengths, your weaknesses. Anything which you don't want, you can just keep deleting and you can add the content the way you want to, because now you know how to create a page. So this section is going to be about you. And finally, we'll come on to this project page. Now this project page, you can create pages for different subjects. So let's rename this particular page. Say this is for English. Now I want to be creating a similar tab for Hindi. So I'll go to duplicate page and then create a page for Hindi. Similarly, I want to create one more page and I will be creating it for science. So I've created it for science. So you can create it for all your subjects in this manner. And then suppose in English, you want to create further sub pages. So you can add a sub page here and you can write, put it as creative writing. You want to add one more sub page to English and can write it as reading assignments. You want to add one more sub page to this, and it could be about your test scores. And remember, I told you to add a page of reflections for each subject. How are you performing in each of the subjects? You can put up your reflections over here. You can, if you want, add a tab of reflections here. So let's see, how is it looking over here? You have got a page, home page, you've got about. In English, you can see there are certain sub pages which you have already created. Similarly, if you create sub page for Hindi, it will appear here. So all your subject pages will be here on the top. You can create as many tabs as you want. And for each page that you are going, you now know how to put up the content on each page. You can choose the layout, you can upload all the content, whichever you want, on your sub pages. So then your portfolio will be ready. And then you can share it. If you want, you want to share it with your teacher before you want to publish it, you can do that. Otherwise, you can go ahead and publish. This is going to be your URL, which you will share with others, those who want to see your portfolio. You have the right to decide who can view your site. So if you select anyone, then anyone can see it. If you go to manage, and then you can, if you want some select group of people only to see your site, then in that case, you have to just share it with those people. And also you have the option that you can request the search engines not to display your site if you don't want it to be displayed. So you can check the box over here. And finally, then you can publish. So once you publish, then this will be visible to the people whom you want it to be visible. So now you can see, I'll finally show you the preview of how your portfolio is looking like. This is how it looks like. And you can make a lot of changes to this portfolio according to your own creativity. This is your about page, subject pages. And you have to keep on continuously working on your portfolio. As you're taking new assignments, you're doing new projects, keep uploading the stuff on your portfolio. So students, I believe that you have understood how to create digital portfolio. If you still have any queries or doubts, please write it in the comments box below and I'll make it sure that I reply to all your queries. Thank you so much and all the best.